Peter say, if you don't want evil to occur, pray to God and ask God to remove the evil. We homocentric religions say no. There is no God. There's only yourself. You don't want evil, you change. You change yourself, like the Japanese did. Don't pray, don't steal, don't do whatever. I've got a dignity. Right? I've got marwah. I'm not going to do it. Alright? Now, you can change. You are a Buddha. You want no evil? No problem. Do it yourself. You don't want evil? Get rid of the evil yourself. How do I explain this? The Chinese have gone all over the world. When they went to look for gold in San Francisco, when they went to look for gold in Australia, they found no gold. They did not sit down and cry. They went and washed clothes for those who found the gold. They did the cooking, alright? And they survived. They survived because homocentric. God is not there to help you. You help yourself. This is the Buddhist one. No one saves us but ourselves. No one can and no one may. We ourselves must walk the path. Buddhas merely show the way. Right? Then show the way how? The fourth, how to do it. And it starts with perfect understanding. The Noble Eightfold Path starts with perfect understanding. When you understand what this world is about, what is your place in this world, then you go about working accordingly. That's why in Taoism we say yin and yang. Everything is in opposites. And when you balance the two opposites, then you have happiness. And this, no talk about God, no talk about praying. How do you balance opposites? You don't want to die in a tsunami? No problem. Go and live in the mountain. And then there will be an earthquake, you come back to this. Okay? You understand? Mana na escape? It is how we perceive. What is suffering? You all know that expression. We are talking about evil. I complain I got no shoes. That is evil? Look at the guy who has no feet. You want to complain? We want to complain about Malaysia and the government and not go to Bangladesh. Go to Africa, where you don't have. We here we talk about traffic jam. There they got no roads. It's all to do with perception. It's all to, when you do that, the Taoists, the Confucianists, and the Buddhists, they are happy people. That's why we use the lotus flower as our symbol. The lotus flower is in the mud. The root is in the mat, smelly, filthy, dirty mud. But the flower comes up from that mud. Here we are. Okay, you got traffic jam. Okay, you got a bad government. Okay, you got corruption. You got all this, that, that. Why then jatuh tangga, nothing per tangga pula? You raise yourself and say, I have nothing to do with this. I will not do the same thing. I will remain above. Okay? So that is right understanding. When you have right understanding, your thoughts, which is the cause of your happy or unhappy. So if you understand evil, then you will not have the wrong thought about this is evil. Okay? You will have the right attitude towards what is perceived as evil. Right, that will lead to right speech, right action, right livelihood. Then, right mindfulness and right concentration. That's the Noble Eightfold Path. But it all falls under right understanding. Right understanding does not mean right praying, right kowtowing, right offering of flowers. This is the way the universe operates. This is the Tao. How do you live according to the Dharma? No need for religion, no need for law. Okay? Now, there are two kinds of evil. The evil that took place in Haiti, that took place the tsunamis, all these physical earthquakes, disease, pests, there's nothing you can do about it. There's nothing you can do. We are so advanced. We don't know when the next earthquake is going to hit. So much for our science and technology. You go and pray every day and tell me whether you can get the next earthquake to come. The Buddhist, Taoist and Confucianists teach you, don't worry when it is coming. Just be ready to die. Can you die now? Or will you say, wait, I grow old first and enjoy life? Okay? Right. Alright. But that one, you cannot do anything about it. But there is a second one, you can do everything about it. Yeah? It is not the suffering, but your attitude to the suffering. The Buddha says, when body is sick, that's evil. When body is sick, don't let mind be sick as well. Bila jatuh tangga, jangan timpa tangga. Okay, you fell down, yes, but don't suffer with the falling. Stay above it. That's Buddhist teaching. Taoist teaching, Confucius teaching. Okay, right. Selfishness, envy, greed, cruelty, war. None of these need to happen. So long as you have all these, look at what's happening in the Middle East. It's a fantastic thing that's happening there. Because what happened to Christian Europe 500 years ago is happening in the Middle East today. For thousands of years, they allowed themselves to be bullied by the Gaddafis and the Mubaraks and all these people. Now the people say, no more. We are not going to take this anymore. Okay? And it had to happen. It had to happen. Right? And where did it come from? Not from God. From the evil of men's minds. See, the Japanese, at least now, didn't have that evil. They didn't say, what about me? Tomorrow I might not have the second loaf of bread. Doesn't matter. The guy behind has no bread. That's more important. I won't celebrate my birthday today. Others, no birthday at all. I cannot. That is not to do with God. That's to do with a noble mind. A noble being. Okay? Right. Selfishness are physical evils. The way the universe is constructed. Yeah? What does that mean? You cannot say, let there be no tsunami. You cannot say, let there be no earthquake. You cannot say, let there be rain. You cannot. That's the way the world is. Dharma. The way the universe is constructed. Dharma. The. Okay? Some of these problems can be eradicated by science. Before, remember, we had malaria. We had tuberculosis. Science came, cleared that up. Then we had AIDS. Now AIDS also cleared. Yeah? Science can get rid of some of these things. But can science get rid of your greed, your anger, your hatred, your jealousy, your fear, your restlessness, your worry, your thinking now, what is this old man talking about, don't understand, my back is aching, now that kind of suffering, okay? Can you get rid of that? Can. Moral evil can be overcome by controlling the mind. When body is sick, don't let mind be sick. Everything depends on our attitude towards our problem. Alright? There are two ways. The tsunami, the Japanese could have curse God could have done.